Welcome to part three of our breaking out series, and our theme is step out in peace and confidence. The world has lost its confidence. Since the 18th century, the age of the so-called Enlightenment, it has been widely believed that human reason and science will prevail over chaos. The 19th century optimism built upon this myth. The unsinkable Titanic was the symbol of this myth of the Western world's greatness. Its sinking was the harbinger for World Wars I and II. We no longer have the confidence that ideas, a reason, science, or even technology of today can answer our problems. In the face of this cultural melee, the scripture readings invite us to step out in peace and confidence in the world that has never had peace and has lost its confidence. We can step out in confidence because we are in Christ's church. In Acts 15, we see the tiny infant church launching out into a world that was dominated by the Greco-Roman culture. They had to face this powerful pagan world as well as their own internal issues. Right off the bat, disagreement threatened to undermine the church. At that time, most of the Christians were Jewish, and there were some among them that taught that everyone had to follow the Jewish customs to be saved. These customs were biblical, for the most part, and time-honored, especially circumcision here in our text, but also diet, keeping the Sabbath and the feast, and even dress. A saved person or a child of the covenant looked a certain way. The question before the first council of the church was, do we need to look Jewish to be a Christian? Do all the Gentile converts have to be circumcised and by extension eat kosher foods, keep the Sabbaths and feast, and dress a certain way? The council argued this out, and through the leadership of Peter came to the answer, no. What makes a Christian are not the externals, but the gift of the Holy Spirit and faith in Jesus Christ. Note the confidence with which the church came to this conclusion. It seemed good to the Holy Spirit and us. In the minds of the apostles, authority is not something completely transcendent, belonging to a divine world way out there beyond the sky. It was here among them in space and time in a church which was in union with Christ through the Holy Spirit. Over 2,000 years, in spite of human failings within the church, the church has held the truth of Jesus Christ in a world that says with Pilate, what is truth? The lesson for us today is that we are in the church. We are in the truth. Therefore, like the early church, we can step out in peace and confidence into our world of today. Our second point is this. We can step out in peace and confidence because the triune God dwells within us. Our gospel reading in John 14:23 tells us the most incredible fact about us. If a man loves me, he will keep my word. my Father will love him. And we will come to him and make our home with him. Now the word home there is the one that's used earlier in verse 2 of chapter 14. Very familiar to us. In my Father's house there are many rooms. Often translated in the old translations, mansions. But you know, actually the word there means a one-room flat. And in John's mind, this takes us back to Ezekiel's temple. After all, in my Father's house, he meant the temple. And in Ezekiel's temple vision, he saw three stories of rooms along the side of the temple. And Ezekiel doesn't tell us what these rooms are for, but John tells us what they're for us to dwell in. God, who once dwelt in the temple, filling it with glory, now dwells with us. I remember the first cathedral I ever saw. I was in France. And I was in Amiens. And I woke up and went out in the morning and I saw the church far off. It looked like a black box with spires. Anyways, I got closer and closer. I could see more detail. And then I went into the winding streets and disappeared from my view. And all of a sudden, boom, there it was in all its wild Gothic splendor. And then when I went inside, it's like the hinge of my neck went straight up. And there, these huge columns raising the roof of this gorgeous edifice to the sky. Now, picture to yourself a beautiful chapel with Gothic ribbed vaults like we have here at this picture of Amiens. A clerestory where light comes in, stained glass windows, magnificently carved statues and altar. Wouldn't you be drawn to such a place? So it is with our magnificent soul. God desires to indwell our interiors, and love is what draws him into our interior. What does it say? If anyone loves me, he will keep my word, and my Father will love him, and we will come and make our home in him. There is no greater or purer pleasure in the entire world than to discover and recognize the Holy Trinity dwelling deep within. When we know this, when we really experience this, then we can step out in peace and confidence because we are possessed with the fullness of God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Well, our third point is this. Step out in peace and confidence because we know our destination. We are not wanderers in this life. Our road leads to John's vision of the Holy City in Revelation 21, verses 10 through 14. Notice its massiveness. This is symbolically expressive in a perfect square, 1,500 miles in breadth, width, and height. In the ancient tabernacle and temple, the only feature that was square was the most holy place, sometimes called the Holy of Holies. It is a symbolic of perfection. The only truly perfect place on earth. This is why John saw no temple, because the whole city of God is the most holy place where heaven and earth are perfectly joined. The whole thing is the Holy of Holies. Its solidness and value is symbolically expressed in the massive blocks of costly jewels and the city of gold, so pure that it's translucent. These architectural details are meant to stimulate our imaginations so as to flood our souls with eternal life, now from the city that is our true home. In fact, this city is the perfect match for our interior temple where the triune God dwells now. That is why we call heaven home. And we say along with the ancient proverb, home is where the heart is. Well, in conclusion, we see a progression over these last 3 weeks, haven't we? The theme of our first week was, we can't stay here. Last week was, look out your door. And today, the challenge is this. Step out in peace and confidence. Step out in peace and confidence into the world around us and take specific, intentional steps to turn the world upside down just like the apostle did. You can do this in concrete ways. Join small prayer groups. Join the evangelization team. Worship. There are a whole lot of places where we can do this. Step out in peace and confidence, and may God bless you.